Hi, welcome to my C.H.A.B.I.S channel cooking today. Oh, by the way, there is the freezer and the fridge and the heating and whatever running in this room. So it's kind of hopeless to try to get a decent sound quality. But it's better than nothing. Well, today we have something very classical, not only in Germany but also in Switzerland. It's simple and easy sauerkraut. Sauerkraut and some bacon inside. This one is some I bought in Germany. So this is a real German sauerkraut, Fasskraut. So barrel. Fass is a barrel and kraut. It's normally cabbage, white cabbage, all put into a barrel actually and made it ferment. It's normally some, probably you call it lactic acid, Milchsäure. What is in here? White cabbage and salt. That's it. And it's still good until December 2017, even though I don't really know when I bought it. Here they say since 1722, but I guess this one is not so old. At the other hand, yeah, it's lasting as long as you may think. This one is in a bag I bought here in Switzerland. That's already cooked, so this wouldn't take less time. This is still good for June 2017. So because it's in the bag, it's probably a bit less well packaged than the other one in this glass. But it's funny because the one in the glass is really lasting a year longer, probably a year more than the other one. Just have a look. This one is 10 to 15 minutes only cooking, so it's prepared too, I guess. Because if it's completely uncooked, you normally have to cook it for, well, around an hour. This one is already made. What's here said? Now that's some, where's the basic recipe? Now I'll open it anyway. This one is normally kept cooled, so I guess This one is even though it just has cabbage and salt in it and nothing, again, except the natural acid, it still lasts very long. And this one is, what is it, about 10 minutes. So this one is cooked, it's more or less just finished. This one is also it's made with wine and so on, so it's this one is the basic stuff here, and this one is the stuff made with white cabbage, of course, but then white wine, salt, sugar, apple and so on, so it's it's more a meal, and this one is a basic ingredient if you want. So I take this in the this one because it does not last as long as the other one. I can keep this one for longer, still for longer than this one. 500 grams, that's more than I need for one serving, but it's not a problem. At one point I love to eat it, and the other one is point is you can eat it tomorrow again and so on. So it lasts after it's cooked still for probably a couple of days, not without any problems. Now I'm checking, does it have the berries in already? No, I like it with a Wacholder. I have to look what it is in English. Where do we have them? That's pepper. Also nice berries, but I'd say they're a bit stronger. Something falling. Ah, here. You see, in German, Wacholderbeeren, Francais, Genièvre, Italian, Ginebra. English is not written here, because English is not an official language in Switzerland. So, let's see what we do. Here we have some, I think it's bacon, Speck, Kochspeck, bacon to be cooked. It's not ham. So this one is, oh, it's already good until November. I'm not in a hurry, everything lasts for the middle of the year at least. So then I'll cut it. I have a look if I can show you without the camera falling over. It's always sort of a problem here because of the angle of the camera. I had it toppling over once. If I'm careful, it will stay. I will move the microphone. Let's try moving it over here. No idea if this is good. It's probably better up here. The problem is this is a stereo microphone. That's not actually bad, but it means it is recording the whole room. It has a spherical way to listen. So you hear everything. I have the other microphone up there in my cold studio, and I don't want to cook up there. Even though technically with this thing you can go everywhere. That's not bad. That's why I like that thing actually. You don't really need to put it in the kitchen, you could put it everywhere. And it does most of the meals. Quite a bit movable here. Seems to be a problem. I turn it a bit so you can see a bit more. I've washed the inside, the pan, quite a bit. So this one could probably be eaten like this, so I don't have to cook it for eternity, and so it will not be a problem. Let's sharpen my knife a little bit. I'm watching too many videos about swords and knives and stuff, even though I don't have much personally. All I have is a let's say the Swiss standard Victorinox kitchen knife. They are relatively cheap or affordable here. Of course you can have cheaper ones which do the job too. But yeah, normally you buy such a thing once. Yeah. Once in your lifetime, or twice maybe, if you manage to. Yeah, if you don't break it or something, it is forever. So I cut some pieces off. I just do it the easy way when I cut the first piece off. I can peel everything out. Oops, the packaging. Probably found out this is not a vegetarian channel. But you can, of course, you can do a lot with sauerkraut. You can do many vegetarian meals and so on, because the base is of course is vegetarian. As I said, cabbage and salt. So I'm packaging whole rest of the bacon. I put into a bag just to we Swiss always recycle, so there is one trash bag for plastics here, one for general trash, one for glass, for aluminium, for, yeah, you name it. So the rest of the bacon stays in the fridge. I'll probably find a way to eat it quite soon. At the other hand, it's salted. It will last for some time. So, actually now I'm ready to ta-da, open the bag of the already prepared meal. You know, technically you could just cook this one even inside the bag. It just needs to be hot, and after you could eat it. There is no need to actually add something if you don't want to. But I decided that I won't do this time. So I put the whole stuff inside without much thinking. It's not yet hot. Because there's no need, I add some water. Because I always add a bit of water. And by the way, I can also collect some of the rests of the sauerkraut sticking to the package. Yeah, I paid for it, I'll eat it, all of it. So this plastics I can put in the special collector bag for plastics. Then I put some of these berries in. Oops, I just like the taste. They are kind of dry. So not sure if they will give much of the taste to the cabbage in this short time. So doesn't matter. So, of course, this one on top, because everything is already salted and spiced and so on, I don't have to add anything more except this one, which I like. So, close the lid. And I add a bit of water and will cook it unpressurized or give it at least a try. No, this doesn't make sense. But I'll still add a little bit more water. Because I'm always a bit unsure if there is not enough water, it really might burn. If there is too much water, it's normally not a problem. You can let it evaporate later on. So I put it to pressurized, close it, because normally you would close your pan too, your pot. Now let's see. I would say they say something about 10 minutes, because I have the meat inside. I want to cook it a little bit. I put it to stew or steam. That's just, I'd say I try steam, vegetable steam, cook time 10 minutes, 15, 6 minutes, 10 minutes, 15. Poo. Yeah, let's give it 10 minutes. 10 minutes of steam. For the sauerkraut, it should be perfect anyway, because it's actually already cooked. So I could have made it by just warming up to the 60 degrees centigrade, which is that makes a bit below 100, a bit under 100 Fahrenheit, I guess. 0 degrees centigrade is 32. If you add 60, you get 92, somewhere around this. You'll end up, after all, who cares? If it goes to cooking, it's not chemistry and physics. Well, of course, it's chemistry and physics all mixed together, but it's not a scientific thing. It doesn't really matter if you have 60 or 65 degrees, or 92 or 95 or 100, but if you put it in your mouth, it's too hot anyway. So you can say too hot, too cold, and burning. Yeah. If it's burnt to ashes, you were too high. Oh yeah. Nice, school wants me to become a scientist, or at least act remotely scientific, and now I'm talking like this. But you know, this computer stuff here looks very scientific, doesn't it? But you really could have put the whole stuff into a pan, or pot, or not sure if the pan more means the frying pan, whatever. You get it. Throw it all in, heat it up to not too much after all, and just wait for 15 minutes. That would have done the trick too. Oh, now the freezer is starting, the compressor is running. You probably don't hear anything but it. So, the camera will probably turn off during cooking. Because it automatically turns off after 30 minutes. By the way, for people wanting to do videos, there is, at one point, photo cameras are perfect. But at another point they aren't, because actually the difference between a photo camera and a film camera is defined by how long it does film in one take, I heard. So technically they are probably absolutely identical. Why should there be any difference, by the way? You need a decent optics, a fast SD card, and that's it. But there is this political detail that the photo cameras stop after 30 minutes of recording video, while the film cameras, the movie cameras, continue as long as there is space left. At the other hand, I have to say this this not quite exactly 30 minutes. I think that mine starts would probably stop in about a minute now, or in 3 to 5 minutes. This makes exactly 3.8 gigabytes of file size, and 3.8 gigabytes is exactly the amount of memory you can address if you have a 32-bit system. So I'm not sure where this 30 minutes exactly are coming from. Technically you can do 200 gigabyte files, that's not a problem. But it's no matter how the computer is actually built inside the camera. Oh, you learn informatics and cooking the same time if you watch my channel. And some other stuff you didn't want to know probably too. Ah, the pot is starting to do something. It's no problem for me to talk for 15 minutes or something. By the way, actually it does heat up the stuff and then it starts counting to 10 minutes. So if you put the cooker to 10 minutes, you have to calculate 15 minutes at least for the whole process to be finished and for you to get the food out, because it has to be heated up, then it's cooking for the time set, and then the pressure has to go down before you can open the lid. And be happy about this. If you open the lid while the pot is still under pressure, it will open much faster than is designed, to put it this way. And I'm not calling first, by the way. I don't do things like this. Okay, he has much more visitors, so it pays, but it also has some costs. So the camera should stop any minute now. Yes. So, second take. 30 minutes of material normally give about a good 10 minutes video, if I don't talk too much nonsense. But if I did, I could always remove the audio. Yeah. I'm not sure if you want to see the whole cooking process uncut, even though it's just 10 minutes. I know how long 10 minutes of nothing happening can be. At the other hand, if you have a speaker from the off, speaking a perfect English, something not quite unlike English, ich kann auch Schweizerdeutsch im Fall, that was Swiss German. Oh yeah, I can do it, a little bit of a language video, because it still says 10 minutes, so the cooking will take probably 15 minutes after. Ah, yeah. Now program changed. It says it has heated up to the desired temperature. It will now hold it for 10 minutes, I'd say. We have the steam program, so the steam program will probably constantly keep temperature. The rice program will probably more or less turn the heating off. That's probably the difference between all those programs. Peng, okay, that was the valve closing, I think, or opening. Not sure. It always makes this pam sound somewhere. It's not from exploding bacon or something. By the way, does it have a popcorn? There is no official popcorn program, but I think in the book there is a recipe for doing popcorn with this thing. At least it's nice and closed. This is the the recipe book. It does contain a couple of possibilities. Yeah, talking about cooking. Books. It's everything falling off. That's my messy system here. But if I finish this book, I can still take this one. And if I finish this one, I guess I'm in the asylum and somebody else is cooking for me. Let's see, these are 1,000 recipes. This one is 100. And then there are some other books. I guess we would get to 1,200 recipes. If I cook one per week, that makes 52 per year. I can take a few years. I'm set for a couple of years. And you can expect another 1,000 videos from me. probably I have to continue doing videos, so... Well, everybody loves to cook. Or loves to eat. Not exactly everybody loves to cook. By the way, I'm not a very sophisticated cook. I would never call myself a really good cook. I can do quite some basic stuff, and if I take some time and recipe and energy, I can do some decent stuff too, some a bit more complicated ones. But I'm not trained, and other trained by doing it often. I'm doing it right now a bit more because I don't have a job. I'm just studying. I actually wanted to work and study the same time. Didn't work out by now really a perfect way, but it's already started the whole stuff. I will get something. No. At least as long as I know a little bit how to cook and pay my electricity and my gas bills, I'll probably get something to eat. So it has been holding the temperature for 4 minutes now. It's perfectly saying how long it takes. Normally I would go to the living room and continue reading Facebook. I should reading accounting actually. We have an exam on next Wednesday. So but I know perfectly what I should do. That's clear so far. I might do some accounting videos, but at the other hand, it's not so great. If I do accounting according to Swiss rules, I can at least make them in Swiss German. I don't have to do them in English. Nobody in English speaking countries will care about how Switzerland is doing accounting. But I'm happy I'm in Switzerland, to be honest. In school we had to do some analysis of US companies, and my goodness, this was a pain in the ass to try to read that stuff. Their annual reports, That's an awful thing. I guess it's highly standardized, so if you finally manage to understand the stuff, you don't have to learn much more because it's always the same. But the learning curve is just astronomic. I'm getting bored. So I'm cleaning up a bit the kitchen, putting away the German sauerkraut I did not need now. And I get my cup of tea. I'm not exactly British, you probably heard it. I somehow try to stick to some remotely British, at least in writing, but I know my speaking is influenced by watching YouTube videos from all over the world, so it's a generic, more generic English. And I still have to look for words. That's funny, by the way. Before I started to do YouTube videos, I was thinking that I'm really good at English. And I'd say I can say I'm fluent most of the time, but whenever I want to explain something specific, some words are missing. That's a pain in the ass, actually. Even though I'm watching a couple of English YouTube videos each day. But I have to look for words, and some words are just not pronounceable, like pronunciation or denomination, or what was it? Recipe is a kind of hard too. I always say receipt, and that's not exactly the same. Even though it's written recipes, well, who cares? As long as I can eat the food, not the recipes and not the receipts. Yeah, whatever, we have been talking about accounting before. Yeah. Oh, now the battery is about to die. That's the funny stuff, you can do whatever. Something is always wanting to kick you in the ass when filming. I guess the battery will probably last for now. It's warning quite early. But it eats up a lot of energy all the time. There is an external power adapter actually for this camera, but of course you always have to buy original equipment, or at least very well compatible equipment. So the power adapter for $2 from AliExpress will not do the trick probably. But now it told me it's finished. So, I do my usual trick you have seen in the other video, this time without burning my hand, I hope. It wasn't bad, by the way, it's all okay, but just hurt for a few hours. So, it now needs to release the steam. Now you get a bit of action. I have to say, that's all the action you can get from this pot. It's it's not actually a dangerous
or
anything. No, you get a decent smell of hot plastic. Nope. Did I take the plastic off before putting in the bacon? Yeah, I know it's written on packages on pizza. On a frozen pizza. We always laugh at it in Europe, actually, because this is sort of a very Anglo-Saxon law thing that everything has to be written on the packaging. Here also, do not touch, it's hot, do not touch, warning, hot steam. Okay, it's okay, they write it, but after all, I still managed to put my hand over it, so I'm still an idiot. They can write it as much as they want. And I don't go to sue them. According to Swiss law, by the way, it wouldn't make much sense. If I really tried to sue a company because I hold my hand over the steam valve of a steam pressure cooker, after I have set that thing to steam for 15 minutes, yeah, the judge probably wouldn't even laugh at me. He just would look a bit annoyed and give me the paper back to go wherever I want with it. So, that looks okay. I know that you don't see it in here, so I'm taking the pot over, the pan. Ouch, I'm still hot. As I said, it's not a surprise. I wanted a hot meal, actually. So I made me a hot meal. Yes. Communication worked in this case. So, I would say this is edible. If you don't see any video from me anymore, you will know it was not edible. But I'm quite sure that shouldn't be the problem. I get myself a fork and a knife. Just give it a try. A kraut is never a problem. And I'd say this one looks cooked enough. Oops. Cutting left-handed is not my biggest. Ouch. Still hot. I know this one is hard. Yep. Everything perfect. And you see, it hasn't been overly painful to get the meal. So, see you, bye.